Good morning, students. Welcome to the Greenfield School and College online classes. Today I'm gonna discuss the chapter 4. You can say it's a review class or revision class, because chapter 4 is very much important for your board exam. Every year one or two question you can get in the exam. Everyone get the exam, so chapter 4 is very much important. And also I noticed that in the pretest in your pretest exam you couldn't answer the simple question, what is the main document of the company, joint stock company. You didn't answer it correctly. The answer is memorandum of association. This is the main document. I didn't get it. How could you just make that type of mistake, that you cannot answer the, you couldn't answer the main document of the company. So obviously this chapter is very much important, and that's why I decided to review it and today's class for chapter 4. This is the revision class, so let's continue. And please continue the class with the book. Textbook is must when you attend the class. Business based on ownership. Business based on ownership means there are four five types of business. You can classify it as a business in five types: sole proprietorship, partnership, joint stock company, cooperative society, and state enterprise. You know, sole proprietorship business is very much easy business, and it is very much ancient business, old business. But it is very much easy to form, easy to dissolve, and just one person can, with his willingness, can start the business easily. So sole proprietorship business just formed and operated and controlled by the single person. That's why it is called sole proprietorship business. And there are no necessities of to follow the rules and regulation, or there is no mandatory rules and regulation for the sole proprietorship business. But if you in a city, if you in town, or if you in cities and towns, then you have to collect the trade license before starting the business. And from this para, the important MCQ is what percentage of the business just sole proprietorship business in Europe and America? The answer is most of the 80% of the business in Europe and America is sole proprietorship business. Generally, tea stall, grocery shop, vegetable shop, hawkers beside the roads. So these are the common example of sole proprietorship business. Characteristics of sole proprietorship business: the owner is a single person. In sole proprietorship firm, who arranges to supply the goods. That means owner is owner have to collect the capital and operates the business and bears the risk. That means the single person, the owner have to bear the risk, and he has to arrange the capital. Formation of this kind of business is very much easy. That means its formation is very easy. There is no legal complexity, legal boundaries. So that's why it is very much too easy. It is very much to dissolve also. This sort of business can be formed with less capital. That means if you have willingness to start the business, and if you can arrange the little more capital, you can easily start the sole proprietorship business. And size of the business is also small. In sole proprietorship firm, the owner has to bear all the risk. Sole proprietorship firm does not have a legal entity, obviously, because there is no legal act for the sole proprietorship business, and also there is no legal boundaries, legal complexities for the formation or execution of the business. So that's why sole proprietorship firm does not have a legal entity. Owner bears all the responsibilities in this business, thus his liability is unlimited. His liability is unlimited, and one may need to sell personal property to meet up the business liability. That means all the profit, loss, liability, everything has to bear by the owner.
Thank you.
Everything has to bear by the owner, so that's why sole proprietorship business is very much easy, and on other hand you can say it is also tough, because when you are liable to meet up the all the borrow lendings, all the loans, to clear the loans, maybe you have to sell your own personal properties for paying up the loan, so that's why it is on the other hand you can say it is also tough for the sole proprietor, tough for the single owner or single person. Owner enjoys all the profit, on the other hand he has to bear all the loss singly. The existence of sole proprietorship business depends upon the willingness of the owner, and that's why when you can shut it down anytime, if you don't want to continue the business, so it is, the shutdown is very much easy, dissolve or dissolution is very much easy. Sole proprietorship business suitable area, there are several sectors you can easily, the sole proprietorship business can easily fit in. In that case, there are some food shop, small food shop, cottage industry, pottery shop. These are the very much common example, tea stall, saloon, betel shop, vegetable shop, such as rice shop, pharmacy, grocery shop. Those are the simple example for sole proprietorship business. Now also for the perishable goods, sole proprietorship business is appropriate. Then doctors, architects, lawyers, they can practice the they can practice their job, they can practice their function in small sector, when they can run the chamber in his own, in the building, in his residence. So these types of profession also act as a sole proprietorship business. Sometimes parlor, saloon, laundry, beauty salon. So those are the sole proprietorship business. Sole proprietorship business suitable for business of goods and services. Sole proprietorship is also suitable for agro-based products. So for publication for publication of books, papers and newspapers at local and national level business, sole proprietorship is more suitable. Okay. Then come to the point, partnership business. What is partnership business? In partnership business means according to 1932 Act, where you can more than one individual, minimum two, and more than one individual willingly comes together to form business on the basis of partnership deed is called partnership business. That means this is the kind of business that is mostly based on the faith, faith, utmost faith, and you can say the relationship among the partners. And also you can also, it is important that partnership deed is must in the partnership business, but this deed is maybe written or maybe oral, but deed is must. According to the 1932 Act, the partnership business is is started, operated and controlled by the partnership deed. So partnership deed is very much important and must for the partnership business. And according to 1932 Act, the member of the general partnership business is 2 to 20, and in banking sector or banking partnership business, the number of member is 2 to 10. Okay, minimum is 2 and maximum 10 in banking sector, but in general partnership business, minimum member is 2 and maximum member is 20. All the partners share profit and loss according to the deed, so deed is must. And who the persons who build the partnership business together, they are called as partner. formation of partnership business, here we already I already told you that partnership business, the partnership deed is very much must for the partnership business, but deed is maybe written or maybe oral, or business may be registered or non-registered. But if you want to avoid any future dispute, any future cases, any future problems, so you have it is very much logical to register the business, and also the deed should be written, and this written deed is called as agreement. Okay, so agreement is to be written. Agreement may be oral, and when the agreement is written form, that is called partnership deed, partnership chukti jetake bola hocche. And the legal, there is no legal complexity. Your formation is very much easy. Two eligible person can easily enter into the contract and start the business, and there compulsory rules and regulation to agreement. The agreement is to be written, but if you want to, I told you that if you want to avoid any legal procedures, contradictions, disputes, unreliability, mistrust, so agreement needs to be written and registered. It will help you in future if you face any type of problems according to the partnership while you're running the business. So that's why if you want to get help, any legal help, the agreement must be written and also registered. So that's why it is logical. And if you are in city or towns, or in the corporation, city corporation or municipality, you have to collect the trade license. Characteristics of partnership business. Formation of partnership business is very easy. Two eligible person can easily enter the business start the business. In general partnership business, minimum member is 2, maximum 20, and in banking partnership business, the minimum number is 2 and maximum number is 10. The agreement between the partners works as the basis for the partnership business. This business is formed, operated, and controlled on the basis of relation based on agreement. The agreement can either be oral or written, registered or unregistered. The partners in the business supply their fund according to the agreement. Obviously, every activities, every sharing, every profit and distribution of profit and loss, capital investment, everything just based on the agreement. The partners just supply the fund or supply the capital according to the agreement. Profit also distributed, loss also distributed according to the agreement. Maybe it is equally distributed, or maybe it is based on the capital amount. The business is formed on the basis of reliability and trust. I told you that partnership business is mainly based on the utmost faith, reliability of the partners, and also the main basis of the partnership business is agreement or partnership deed. So that's why it is mainly based on the reliability and trust. Registration of partnership business firm is not mandatory, but if you want to face any legal hassles, legal disputes, so it is logical to register the business. Deed of partnership business, I told you, when agreement is written, it is called partnership deed. That means written agreement is called as partnership deed. And according to the Partnership Act 1932, partnership relation is built from the agreement, not from status. So agreement is must. Agreement mainly agreement upor base kore partnership business ta hocche. Thik ache, so written agreement is called partnership deed, and it is a guideline. It just acts as a guideline for the partners. So that's why it is very much important. Contents of the deed of the partnership business, when the agreement is written, it is called partnership deed, and in this deed you have to put some issues like name and address of the partnership business, nature, objective and scope of business, expiration or validity of the business, name, address and profession of the partners, total capital of the firm, capital to be paid by each partner and payment method, rules and run the business, introduction of the partners who will directly run the business, profit and loss, responsibilities, name of the bank, address and nature of the account, name of the partners, guideline to include new partner, estimation, reservation, repayment, retirement and dismissal, solution method for future, method of dissolution of partnership. So these are the issues you have to put down in the partnership deed. Registration of partnership business. Registration of partnership business, you have to submit the application to the registrar, government appointed office at the of the registrar, and you have to submit some documents with the application like name of the partnership business, address of the head of the office, address of the branches, objectives of the business, date of business commencement, expiry or validity of the business, partner's name and address, profession, date of joining as a partner. So everything, after checking everything, if registrar is satisfied, he will give you the registration certificate, and or you get the receipt later. You will get the letter from the registrar, and this is the registration certificate. So after getting that, you will easily start the business. So you can easily start the business, so that you can in future you don't have to face any problem, or if you face any problem, you will get the legal help easily. So that's why registration is very much logical for the partnership business in today's world. Now, classification of partners, it is very much important. There are six types of partners in partnership business: ordinary partner, sleeping partner, nominal partner. Ordinary partner, you know, they invest capital, they participate in operational activities, they have the unlimited liabilities, equally share profit and loss. Also, if it is mentioned in the agreement, they can get the remuneration from the business. Then sleeping partner just invest the capital. But the sleeping partners just don't play any role in the operational activities, get the profit as per agreement, and they have this limited liability, their liabilities are limited, and they are not liable to any other third parties of the business. So this is sleeping partner. Nominal partner does not invest capital, does not participate in the operational activities. He just allows to use the name or goodwill of against the profit sharing or in return of particular amount of money as per deed of agreement. That means he just gave you the goodwill. He just gives you the goodwill, good name of his to use in the organization against the particular amount of money or the profit sharing as per agreement. So that is nominal partner. Nominal partners have also limited liabilities, but if anybody just lends some money to the nominal partners, the nominal partner will be responsible to paid up the money. Now, quasi partner means this type of partner just does not withdraw money from the business when they retire. He just keep it in the business as a loan. So they are the mainly creditors to the business. They retire, but they do not withdraw the capital money or invested money from the business, just keep it in the business as a loan. So that's why quasi partner are called as creditors to the business. But if any ordinary partner remains in the business in such way without publishing noting, that means publishing, then he or she will be liable to the third party for the activities of the business. Tar mane hocche je quasi partner kono sadharon partner quasi partner hoye geche mane retire kore geche seta jodi biggopti diye janano na hoy tahole kintu she third party er kache dayabaddho thakbe. তুমি যখনই কোয়াসি পার্টনার হয়ে যাবে, সাধারণ অংশীদার থেকে জেনারেল অর্ডিনারি পার্টনার থেকে তুমি যখন কোয়াসি পার্টনার হয়ে যাবে আফটার রিটায়ারমেন্ট, ইউ হ্যাভ টু অ্যানাউন্স ইট, ইউ হ্যাভ টু পাবলিশ দ্য নোটিস। সো উইদাউট পাবলিশিং এনি নোটিস, ইউ উইল বি ফুল রেসপন্সিবল টু দ্য থার্ড পার্টিস অফ দ্য বিজনেস। সো দ্যাটস ওয়াই কোয়াসি পার্টনার ইজ, if you turn into a if you change yourself into a quasi partner, you have to just publish the notice to the others. Then limited partner means here as per the agreement, any minor can act as a partner, any minor can be partners if it is mentioned in the agreement, if it is mentioned in the partnership deed, and they have also limited liabilities, does not take part in the business operation. Any minor person can also be such partner on the basis of deed of agreement. Limited, they also invest capital, limited amount of the liability of the partner is limited, and amount of capital he just invests the capital. So limited partner is the minor, any minor can be partner if it is mentioned in the agreement. They invest the money to the business, they does not take part in the business operation. So these are the basic characteristics of limited partner. Partner by holding out that means তারা আচরণে বুঝায় সে পার্টনার। দ্যাট মিন্স ওয়েন এনি পার্সন ইন্ট্রোডিউস হিমসেলফ অ্যাজ দ্য পার্টনার অফ আ বিজনেস ভার্বালি, রিটেন অর এনি আদার ম্যানার, দো হি ইজ নট আ পার্টনার, হি ইজ কল পার্টনার বাই হোল্ডিং আউট। মানে সে আইনগতভাবে সে তোমার পার্টনার না, কিন্তু সে তার আচরণে লিখিত বা মৌখিক যে কোনোভাবে সে বুঝাচ্ছে সে পার্টনার, কিন্তু আইনগতভাবে তার নাম কোথাও নেই, তাহলে এই ধরনের পার্টনারকে বলা হচ্ছে পার্টনার বাই হোল্ডিং আউট। মানে দ্য পার্সন, এনি পার্সন ইন্ট্রোডিউস হিমসেলফ অ্যাজ এ পার্টনার থ্রু ভার্বালি, থ্রু রিটেন অর থ্রু এনি আদার মিন্স, বাট দো দে ইজ নট লিগালি পার্টনার, দে আর নট লিগালি পার্টনার, দ্যাট ইট ইজ কল্ড পার্টনার বাই হোল্ডিং আউট। বাট ইফ এনিবডি লেন্স মানি টু দিস টাইপ অফ পার্টনার, দ্য পার্টনার উইল বি দিস এই দিস পার্টনার বাই হোল্ডিং আউট অবভিয়াসলি রেসপন্সিবল টু দ্য থার্ড পার্টিস। মানে সে আচরণে বোঝাচ্ছে সে পার্টনার, কিন্তু আসলে সে আইনগতভাবে পার্টনার না। কেউ যদি তাকে কোনো টাকা ধার দিয়ে থাকে, অবভিয়াসলি তাকে সেই ধার পরিশোধ করতে হবে। তখন যদি সে বলে যে না আমি তো এখানকার আইনগত পার্টনার না, তখন সেই কথা মানা হবে না। ঠিক আছে, তাহলে এই গেল হচ্ছে ক্লাসিফিকেশন অফ পার্টনার্স। অ্যান্ড ডিসলিউশন অফ পার্টনার্স, ইট ইজ ভেরি মাচ ইজি। ডিসলিউশন বাই মিউচুয়াল কনসেন্ট, ওয়েন অল পার্টনার্স আর মিউচুয়ালি এগ্রিড টু ডিসলভ দ্য বিজনেস, দেন ইট ইজ ডিসলিউশন বাই মিউচুয়াল কনসেন্ট। ফোর্স ডিসলিউশন, ওয়েন is just business becomes anti legal or illegal of any reason, that means business acts as a illegal operation, just involved in illegal operation, then it will be forced dissolution. Or maybe one partner become bankrupt, then it will be also forced dissolution. Eventual dissolution, when a specific time period is done, then business ends, it is eventual dissolution. Or maybe a specific task for which the business started is finished, then it will be eventual dissolution. If any partner, in case of death of any partner, it will be eventual dissolution. And if any partner declared is bankrupt by the court, then it will be eventual dissolution. Dissolution through notice, here according to the section 43 Partnership Act, that partnership business can be dissolved through the notice by any partner of his desire to quit the business. তার মানে হচ্ছে যে কোনো একজন পার্টনার যদি বিজ্ঞপ্তি দিয়ে অন্যদেরকে জানায় যে আমি আর কন্টিনিউ করতে চাচ্ছি না, ইট উইল বি ডিসলিউশন থ্রু দ্য নোটিস। ডিসলিউশন থ্রু দ্য নোটিস ইজ based on the section 43 according partnership act section 43. So after that, dissolution through notice, after dissolution by the order from the court, that means you have to dissolve from by the order of the court. So when you have to follow this, if any partner becomes insane or brain deformity phase, any brain deformity, if partners becomes incapable forever, if the trust and faith among the partners are affected by the misdeeds of any partner, if any partner transfer his share to any third party by violating the terms and condition of the partnership deed, if the business is incurring continuous loss, so in these cases, court will order you to dissolve the business. তার মানে কেউ পাগল হয়ে গেলে, কেউ চিরতরে কাজ করার ক্ষেত্রে অসমর্থ হয়ে গেলে, বিশ্বাস নষ্ট হলে, কোনো পার্টনার যদি তার অংশটা কাউকে থার্ড পার্টির কাছে দিয়ে দেয়, ট্রান্সফার করে দেয় উইদাউট এনি পারমিশন অফ আদার পার্টনার, অ্যান্ড কোনো বিজনেস যদি কন্টিনিউয়াস লস ফেস করতে থাকে, সেই ক্ষেত্রে কোর্ট অর্ডার দিয়ে তোমাকে ডিসঅ্যালোড করে দেবে. সো দিজ আর দ্য বেসিক, অ্যাকর্ডিং টু 1932 অ্যাক্ট, দিজ আর দ্য বেসিক ডিসলিউশন প্রসেস. ইউ হ্যাভ টু সিলেক্ট ইট ফ্রম ইউর অ্যাকর্ডিং টু ইউর সিচুয়েশন. সো ইন টুডেজ ক্লাস আই হ্যাভ জাস্ট ডিসকাস দ্য সোল প্রপার্টিশিপ অ্যান্ড পার্টনারশিপ. ইট ইজ আ রিভিশন ক্লাস. আই টোল্ড ইউ. সো প্লিজ with me, you have to also study it and you have to revise it until or unless you cannot write down the answer. I was very much disappointed when I was checking your copy, pretest copy, and you couldn't answer the simple question, the what is the main document of joint stock company. It is, the answer is memorandum of association. You just wrote down different type of answers. So I was very much disappointed. That's why I decided to discuss it with you again, this chapter. And in your test exam, you will obviously get two questions from this chapter. Minimum one, maximum two questions. Also in your board exam. So you please do not skip this chapter. I repeat, do not skip this chapter. Try to read out clearly, thoroughly, and just memorize the important information. So that's all for today's class. Keep it up.